Hello and welcome to my video in where I give you everything you need to know on where in your signal chain you should put your HM2 or your clone. The day I bought my first HM2, I had to decide how to use it and where to put it in my rig. So I did a lot of trial and error until finally finding a way that fits me most. You can hear the result in every Chainsaw Files comparison that I did. But there are more ways, and one of them might fit your style or tonal preferences more. We can generally differentiate between four options. Number one, the HM2 is put in front of the amp. The amp's channel is clean. Legend says that this is the only way to get the true and pure Swedish death metal sound that all the legends used. Well, okay. Number two, the HM2 is put in front of the amp and the amp is set for a crunch sound. With this method, the amp and the HM2 are both more or less equally responsible for the distortion. Number three, the HM2 is put in front of the amp and the amp is set for a full distorted metal sound. Here, the HM2 functions as an overdrive like a tube screamer, with most of the distortion coming from the amp itself. This is my preferred method. Number 4. The HM2 is put in the effects loop of the amp and acts as a preamp. The actual preamp of the amp is not used at all. So let's check out every option. As an amp, I use my Hisso Little Bastard. At first, you are going to hear the riff without the HM2 with the amp setting I think to sound best. Then I activate the HM2 and you hear the riff again. The HM2 is maxed except for the gain knob, which I set to fit the best. After that, we compare all four HM2 sounds directly to each other. I said in the beginning that I prefer the third way with a distorted amp and the HM2 in front of it as a boost. After this comparison, I still like this way, but I have to admit that the Crunch amp with less gain and more gain coming from the pedal sounds better in my ears. It could be that I dialed in too much gain, so more gain doesn't equal better sound. All in all, second and third sounded quite similar, with second being more open or raw, if you want to call it this way, and third sounding more compressed. The first and fourth way sounded totally different and less aggressive than the other two, but similar to each other. I prefer the first way. It sounds chunky with some good grind. It's not my preferred standalone tone, but might be a good secondary tone for production. The fourth way clearly misses an additional EQ section to fit my liking. It sounds quite dull. So my personal ranking based on this sounds: place 4, the effects loop; place 3, fully distorted amp; place 2, clean amp; winner, distorted amp with less gain. And now I'm curious, please share in the comments what your favorite sound is out of this four.
And that's all for today. I hope you enjoyed this video and I could broaden your horizon. Please give this video a like, leave a comment and share it with your friends. If you didn't like it, please let me also know why, because that's the only way I can improve my future uploads. Everything helps, especially if you make sure to subscribe to my channel to help it grow. Thank you so much for watching and have a nice day.